After the end of World War II, the Tydings-Mcduffie Law of 1934 stipulated that the Philippines had finally become an independent republic by July 4, 1946. But to secure the republic's alliance with the United States, a series of treaties and agreements were signed strengthening the ties of both countries. Some of these were the Bell Trade Act, which imposed free trade and enforced imports from U.S. to 28 years. Parity Rights, allowing U.S. citizens to have equal access to the country's natural resources, and the Philippine Rehabilitation Act, Military Bases Agreement, Military Assistance Pact, which allowed U.S. to use the Philippines for their military bases and control over the military forces of the Philippines. With the U.S. support to the Philippines, culture during this period developed according the ideological direction set by the U.S. This was secured by the Educational Exchange Program or the Fulbright Program. Filipino artists, writers, and musicians were given a chance to stay in U.S. to learn about the country and were also given lecturing privilege to keep the American influence in the Philippines. It made them able to keep up with the literary and artistic trends of U.S. during that time. Fresh from studies in American universities, a number of these writers introduced new criticism, which is a critical method emphasizing close analysis of text and structure.
Taga-bukid and Taga-bayan. These were the two cultures that made up the political entities.
Meron tayong panauhin. Halika't salubungin natin sila. Magandang araw, mga kaibigan.
Magandang araw.
Magandang araw.
Halika kayo sa aking bukid. Malawak na bukid. Dito namin kinukuha ang kinakain namin sa pang-araw-araw. Dito na naman makikita ang aking mga pananim na gulay. Tara, pasok kayo sa aking munting tahanan. Pasok. Dito kayo't maupo.
Ang sarap mamuhay dito sa inyo, maliwalas, masarap ang simoy ng hangin at tahimik.
Tama ka riyan. Kaya naman, pwede niyo subukan sa amin sa bayan.
Sa bukid kaysa dito sa bayan. Mas payapa. Uuwi na lang kami.
Pasensya na sa hindi nyo magandang karanasan dito sa bayan. Hayaan nyo sa susunod, babawi kami. Pasensya na ulit.
Paalam!
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 It's been a month since you borrowed that money, and since then, you haven't paid it yet.
Tritan Severo, but my husband is sick.
It's not our problem. We just want our money back now. We don't
care if your husband is sick.
Because the farmers didn't take it anymore, the cruelness of the Don and Doña, they set a plan for their own right.
Papalag pa kayo sa pang-alipin nila, dapat gumawa na tayo ng paraan para hindi na tayo inapin ng ganito.
Tulong ako sa inyo, Dano. Hindi dapat pinabaliwala ang mga karapatan, lalo na kung pansarili.
Ngunit dahil sa kasakiman ng mga grande, tinangkali lang kami ng lupain.
Kailangan gumawa tayo ng paraan para mapigilan sila.
Ngunit nakarating ang balita sa mga grande at nalaman ni Bitay na may galit ito sa kanya, kaya sinubukan nilang dalhin ang problema sa korte.
Tingin ko, dapat na natin itong dalhin sa korte dahil hindi na ito makatarungan.
Aba, dapat lang. Masyado na silang malapit. Sa huli ay napawalang salary ng mga inosenteng mahihirap at nabigyan ng justisya.
March 17, 1957, when Ramon Magsaysay died in a plane crash in Cebu, the country was under confusion and the people began to ask Recto for some answers regarding the country's political philosophy. However, Recto died in Rome. The cultural scene in the Philippines became an extension of the U.S. Literary works which were brought to Manila were poetry, fiction, and drama, and the latest literary films in the West spread in the country. Another inspiration for writers in Filipino was the launching of the Palangka Awards for Literature, headed by Carlos Palangka Sr. in 1950. Awards were given to writers of short stories, plays, and poetry. In 1961, when Jose Maria Sison organized the SCAUP, or Student Cultural Association of the University of the Philippines, anti-imperialist ideas of Recto were built as a basis of the Philippine and nationalism. And with the help of current President Carlos P. Garcia, adopting the Philippine First Policy, it became an economic nationalism. Under Justado Macapagal's administration, Independence Day was shifted from July 4 to June 12. English literature at that time was more popular instead of Tagalog literature because it could only find space in campus publications. This period marked a struggle of Filipino writers to put back Tagalog poetry and fiction rather than English writing, which were composed of the elder writers. In 1970, mass rallies and marches in public places, as well as violence and death and mass actions, were recorded and they announced in newspapers, radios, and televisions.
New songs and plays were created which carry messages of the nationalist movement.
Panulat para sa kaunlaran ng sambayanan o bansa, which was a group of nationalist writers whose literature was political in content and it then came out was founded. During 1972, with the nationalist movement gaining strength and posing a threat to the government, President Ferdinand Marcos declared the country under martial law. They came up with songs and dramas that fired up the resistance and exposed military abuses against citizens and struggle of the mass. Writers could no longer write freely, which is why they went underground so that they can continue what they were doing.
Okay, Baka, malayang kilos ng Bagong Kababaihan, organization of women whose purpose was to produce female literary artists and with the intent of spreading feminist consciousness. Some of the female literary writers included were Luwalhati Bautista, Joy Barrio, and Rosario Cruz.
Cultural presentations later became a vibrant socially conscious, which also enjoyed profitability because of the interest of paying audiences. Many Filipino playwrights emerged and theater activity all over the country was bolstered. And the revolution, 1986, this period marked the end of Marcos' dictatorial leadership.
Unfolds this. you took your time with